Asia Uncut, brought to you by Electronic Arts and Crown Relocations.
My next guest is one of India's most noted filmmakers. His films, including the hit Rang de Basante, are some of the biggest blockbusters in India and have sparked a new generation of filmgoers. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Rakesh Om Prakash Mehra. Nice having you here. Rang de Basante. Big film, really struck a chord with the Indian youth. Kind of going against corruption, injustice, yeah. Got them all rallying, is that right?
It's crazy because the film is inspired from real life incidences. There was this huge scam going on in the defense about the MiG aeroplanes, the fighter planes.
Right.
And they were crashing and young pilots were dying. So that was the key of the film. And so I borrowed from there. And borrowed from my college life, then made a film out of it.
Is it tough in Bollywood? Do you find that there are a lot of critics, that there's a lot of competition, especially as more of the films are going to the West now?
For me, it's not a question of being whether it's tough or easy. It's a way of life, and I love making movies, and that's all I can do.
That's good. And you've had the BAFTA.
It was a nomination.
A nomination.
A nomination. Yes.
That just
that
is
was
good.
A Rang de Basante. Yeah, it did well there.
I know a lot of my friends from India, they were very excited when you were coming on because they love this film. We have a little bit of a clip, Rang de Basante.
Oh, wow.
Can we show it?
Super.
I always believed there were two kinds of men in this world. Men who go to their deaths screaming, and men who go to their deaths in silence. Then I met the third kind.
Talking during the clip there, it's about the juxtaposition of the past and the present.
I wanted to make a film on the armed revolution of India, which was in the year 1919 to 1933, which was a resistance movement against the British Raj. And there was a bunch of youngsters and it spread like fire all over the country that time. And the average age of the youth at that point of time was 23 and a half. And the youth today in India at 23 and a half was busy jumping parties.
Right.
Or chasing a career at best. And the whole thing about nation, patriotism was the last thing on their mind.
So, of course, movies like Slumdog Millionaire, I guess you get asked about all the time. Very popular in the West. Was it a hit in India?
On the box office, it didn't do well in India.
That's
because
interesting.
Yeah, it's very interesting. In fact, before the film was released, we all saw it. And in fact, I saw it, I'd met Danny Boyle and we had a chat on it and we met over dinner. And he was also wondering, I don't know how the movie will do back home in India. It's not important actually how it did in India. Essentially, it's an Indian story. It's a story of hope as seen from a Western perspective. And it's a story about love, and it's a piece of art, it's a work of art.
So tell us about Delhi 6.
Delhi 6, as the name connotes, is the pin code ID of old Delhi. India is a weird country, it's a complex culture. You have taps, there's no water, you have bulbs, there's no electricity, you have school, there are no books, you have books, there are no teachers. You find teachers, there are no exams happen, the results get delayed, you don't get admission into colleges. You get a degree, you won't get a job. You'll get a wife, you'll never get a house. If you get a house, there will be taps, there will be no water.
So once again, full circle. Here we go. I like that.
And today, the focus is on India. And it is working. It's not only working, it's galloping. The wheel is turning very fast. Economically, social reforms, political reform, medical, law and order. It's a country to watch. But how the hell does it work? And that was the question with which I went into the film. And as we went along, we found the answer that it's the people of the country. They make it work. So when millions of people come together and their heart beats, and every day, every morning when they step out on the road, there's so much of hope in their heart that's what makes it work.
Any desire to work in Hollywood itself, or you're happy doing it from Bollywood?
I think for me, my destiny, duty, or whatever you may call it, it's more important that I can tell Indian stories to the world, and they would like me to be telling Indian stories rather than hearing their own stories from me.
Anything else coming out?
I think I'm ready for a romantic film.
Excellent.
I think I'm young enough now to actually discover romance.
Oh, absolutely. I think you're ripe for romance. I could feel it already.
You can see the white beard. Yeah.
You're good.
We are also creating a studio with a lot of youngsters from all over the country, from small villages, so they can come together. We're giving scholarships, so we'll discover young filmmakers from small town India.
Terrific. Well, it's been an absolute pleasure having you on our show.
Pleasure is all mine.
We'll look forward to seeing you in India sometime. We're going to take Ajahn Cut over to India.
Absolutely.
We're going to hang. Can we hang with you? You've got a restaurant over there. Can we go to one of your restaurants?
It's a family business. It belongs to my brother. Yeah, absolutely. All day, and you'll get to eat the spicy Indian curry.
Sweet. I'm liking that. Rakesh, thanks a lot.
My pleasure. Appreciate
you coming on Ajahn Cut. And that's all we have time for tonight. Thanks to all my guests for being with us. Until next week, keep it uncut. If you like your Asia Uncut, visit here.
Asia Uncut, brought to you by Electronic Arts and Crown Relocations.